F-35 Lightning II is known for its stealthy profile. But there's another side to it in which it can pack more weapons and is popularly known as Beast Mode. In this mode, the F-35 can carry up to 4 times payload when compared to its normal mode. This mode makes the F-35 a completely different adversary to deal with for a rival and could be used in certain scenarios. Beast Mode adds a lot of tactical flexibility to the nations which are deploying the F-35s. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the deployment of F-35 in Beast Mode in HMS Queen Elizabeth aircraft carrier. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. American-made British F-35s have taken off and landed on the HMS Queen Elizabeth aircraft carrier for the first time recently. The tests of part of Westland 19, and the aim of the trial is to make sure that the F-35s work with HMS Queen Elizabeth. The idea is to have an end-to-end testing to ascertain that the two platforms are properly integrated and F-35s can be deployed from the HMS Queen Elizabeth seamlessly going forward. The tests involve mission planning, using automated weapon handling system of the carrier to load weapons, undertaking aerial missions, and debriefing on completion. As per plans, the fighter planes will be jointly manned by the Royal Air Force and the Royal Navy, and can operate from land and sea. The UK is expected to declare initial operating capability for the carrier strike by the end of 2020. The first operational deployment for HMS Queen Elizabeth 617 Squadron and a squadron of US Marine Corps Lightning Jets is due to take place in 2021. New images released indicate that the F-35s were also deployed in Beast Mode. The Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II, which is a single-seat, single-engine, all-weather, stealth, multi-role fighter, is undergoing final development and testing by the United States. The Pentagon began the F-35 program in 2001 with an aim to develop a cost-effective replacement for the U.S. military's F-15 fighters, F-16 and F-18 fighter bombers and reconnaissance aircraft, and A-10 close-in support warplanes. The F-35 has 3 main models: the conventional takeoff and landing F-35A, the short takeoff and vertical landing F-35B, and the catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery carrier-based F-35C. Apart from the United States, the primary customer and financial backer, the United Kingdom, Italy, the Netherlands, Canada, Turkey, now removed, Australia, Norway, and Denmark are also part of the program. Many other nations like Japan and Israel are also deploying the fighters. The 9 major partner nations, including the US, plan to acquire over 2,000 F-35s through 2035, which, if delivered, will make the F-35 one of the most numerous jet fighters. The fighter aircraft are expected to remain in service beyond 2050. Britain will field a fleet of 138 F-35s. It plans to initially acquire 48 F-35B that will be jointly operated by the Royal Air Force and Royal Navy. Out of this, 16 have been already delivered. A subsequent order is expected that will have a mix of F-35B and F-35A. F-35, being a fifth-generation fighter, is developed from the ground up to be stealthy. Its external structure is designed to deflect signals away from the emitting radar, which makes it hard to detect or track. This is done by having no sharp edges or protruding elements, and having a smooth external curvature. It also has a coating of RAM, that's radar-absorbing material, that reduces the number of signals getting reflected. F-35 has the lowest radar cross-section, RCS, of all the jets, except the F-22 Raptor. Against X-band radars, it's stealthy from the front and rear. Against S-band radar, it's stealthy from the narrow front aspect. Against L-band radar, the limited reduction is achieved from the direct front. Classified techniques have also been used to reduce the heat signature of F-35. This thermal profile management of the jet makes it difficult for infrared (IR) homing missiles to target it. It's a genuinely low observable (LO) platform. Importantly, in stealth configuration or mode, weapons are carried internally. F-35s in stealth mode will be used when it's deployed in the initial days of the campaign to penetrate enemy territory that fourth-generation fighters will find difficult to handle. It will neutralize air as well as ground threats and provide critical intelligence. Essentially, in stealth mode, it will be used to gain air dominance. But once this is achieved, F-35 can be deployed in beast mode, where it can carry weapons and external hardpoints too. In stealth mode, the F-35 can carry 5,700 pounds of ordnance, but when it converts to beast mode, it will be able to carry up to 22,000 pounds of payload, internal and external weapons combined. The 22,000 pounds capacity will mean, in beast mode, F-35 will be able to carry several different combinations of various weapons. 1. Paveway 4 is the latest iteration of the Paveway series. It's a dual-mode GPS or INS and laser-guided bomb manufactured by Raytheon UK. 2. ASRAM is the British replacement for the AIM-9 Sidewinder, and it's specially integrated on the F-35 for the Royal Air Force and Royal Navy. It's produced by MBDA and is designed for visual range combat. It has a range of operation of 15 miles or 25 kilometers and a speed of Mach 3+. 3. The Meteor BV RAM is also expected to be integrated on the aircraft, as the Royal Air Force recently declared it operational. It will eventually replace the AMRAM in the next years. The missile is designed from the ground up to meet not only today's threats, but also the future ones, and is considered to be the best BVR, beyond visual range, air-to-air missile. It's capable of engaging fast, agile jets to small, unmanned aerial vehicles, as well as cruise missiles in extreme weather conditions. It has a range of around 95 miles or 150 kilometers, and a speed of Mach 4. The missile has a no-escape zone of 37 miles or 60 kilometers, which is the largest for a missile of this category. F-35 is a multi-role fighter, and with beast mode, it will be able to adapt seamlessly as per the requirements of the battle situation. It's important to note that though it will lose the stealth edge in this mode, F-35s will still be better than any fourth-generation fighter when it comes to many aspects, like situational awareness, thanks to its sensor fusion capability. The same fighter could be used to execute a mission on the first day, as well as at the end of the battle. This will provide excellent operational flexibility to the British military, especially since it doesn't have a dedicated stealthy air superiority fighter like the F-22 Raptor of the US. As the fighter completes its integration with the HMS Queen Elizabeth aircraft carrier, the duo will form a deadly combo, as the carrier can deploy up to 36 F-35s.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.